Hallelujah. Nice to be with you again. Thank you so much. Thank you very much for all of you that love truth and love righteousness, that is craving for a new day, a new earth that will be without all this evil that we are seeing. That is a truth that's trusting heaven to sanitize this earth. I say God bless you real good. God bless all of you as you love truth. Because truth is life. Keep loving truth. Anywhere you see truth, try to be there. God is there. Because God is truth. Our God is a truth God. So, and himself is life. Life that you need, that we need, that I need. Okay. I want to talk about this something now because it's important. You know, it's important for me to talk about this. So many people that is doing, that is into YouTube, that is, let me talk about, okay, YouTubers, some of the YouTubers, especially the African YouTubers, their main purpose of setting up their channel, and when they start, they use church, pastor to start, is for them to gather people, is for them to have subscribers, is for them to have followers. Not because they love Jesus or because of what is going in Africa or going in the world or in the church is paying them. No. They always use it because they know that so many people want to hear about church, about a pastor. Okay, this pastor did this with a woman, or this pastor bought this, or this pastor did this and did that, because it's what is trending, because it's what the devil have pushed so many people, especially Africans, to be using the name of the Lord to be causing havoc to their fellow Africans. So many of them started with this to draw people, not that they love God, not that they love Jesus, not that they love God's children. And it's a pain in the heart of God for such a people, because it's a high, in the eyes of God, is a high sin. It's one of the sin that God hates, deceit. How can that our continent be good if we keep or harbor deceit inside of us? Without abhorring deceit, the first step for knowing God, or for you to know God, is to abhor deceit, to speak the truth from the inner man, from the inside of you, to speak the truth from the inside, to abhor. When you are giving your life to Jesus, if it comes from the deep down of your heart, I don't need to tell you this man is a fake man of God, this pastor is a fake pastor, or this is not a house of God. You will know by yourself if you totally give your life to Jesus and you are craving for righteousness. There is no way for any man or anyone to deceive you. But when we are giving our life to Jesus, we keep some things. Say, Jesus, come into my life. This ear, don't touch it. Don't come this side. Eh? You know, or you are giving your life to Jesus because you want him to heal you, you want him to prosper you, you want him to give you one thing or the other. You have a reason of giving your life. Not that you are giving your life to him because he is God, that you want to know him and the power that raised him from the dead. No, you have your own selfish interest that is hidden that caused you to come to him. You are not giving your life in totality to him. This is deceit. I can show you in the Bible, you want to see one of the things that God hates, one of the sin that God hates. If I can find it now, if I can find it quickly, I will love to read it for you to understand. It is very, very important if I can be able to find it now and read it for you to understand. Let me try. I think it can get it. So, if I get it, it will be very, very nice. Because this video, I want you to listen. Okay, I think I found it in the book of Proverbs. I think I found it. Okay, thank you, Jesus. I found it. Okay, Proverbs chapter 6. I want to read this for you. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. These six things the Lord hates. Indeed, seven are an abomination to him. 17. A proud look. The spirit that makes one overestimate himself and underestimate others. A lying tongue. Say number one, a proud look. The spirit that makes one overestimate himself and underestimate others. Another one, a lying tongue. Another one, and hands that shed innocent blood. Another one, verse 18, a heart that manufactures wicked thoughts. A heart that manufactures wicked thoughts and plans. Another one, feet that are swift in running to evil. Feet. Feet that are swift in running to evil. 19. A false witness who breathes out lies, even under oath. And he who sows discord among his brethren. Who sows discord among his brethren. So I think a false witness who breathes out lies even under oath, and he who sowed discord among his brethren. You know what I think one person said, you know, a deceitful tongue. Let me see. Wait. I want to check another version. Let me see another version. What he said here is important. Just give me some minutes. Okay, I think it's the same thing. Okay, I read. These six things the Lord hates, yes, seven are an abomination to him. A proud look, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked plans, feet that are swift in running to evil, a false witness who speaks lies, and one who sows discord among brethren. Yes, there's I think we find it, you know. Deceitful tongue is what God talked in one particular place. But okay, we can move on. So now what am I trying to say? Now they all jumped inside, and there, many of them are still doing it, still talking about it, about pastors, churches, this and that. But something is going on. Somebody have come up now. Somebody is threatening them now that they will start shutting their channel down. So I already smell, I see fear in the life of so many of them. They are like trying to begin to make friends with the people that is threatening them because of what they are doing, what they are talking about them. So they are threatening them that they will also start shutting down their channel. So many of them is panicking now. He's shaking. So many of them will begin to dilute their truth. When they want to talk about them, they will dilute it so that it will not, they will begin to polish, their word. They are becoming more conscious, more careful, so that they will not shut down their channel. The same way you are trusting God to shut down their church so that Jesus will be glorified. You yourself, you are afraid of their threat of shutting down your own church. Your channel is your own church. You are also afraid that if your church is founded on the rock, that even if they shut it, that Jesus that you are calling, if he's in the matter, if he's only commissioned you, that he will show himself mighty. It's not better for them to shut it because of the truth you are speaking. It's not better for them to shut your channel down because you are saving souls. You are opening the eyes of the people. It's not better for you to, if you are truly doing it for the kingdom of God, not because of the money you are making from your channel, not because of the subscribers and viewers. So many of you are panicking already. You are panicking because they are sending a signal of shutting down your channels. I don't care. Who cares? I don't care. Because I am not making my channel because of I want to make money out of it. I want people. No. I don't care. I don't care who is that person that will tamper with my channel. I don't care. Because Jesus instructed me. I sent it to use it to glorify, to do the will of God. This is my purpose of telling you to come here and hear what God is saying, to subscribe, to receive the word of God, to know what God is saying and the direction. So if you are afraid of them shutting down your channel, which means you are not sure, you are deceitful, you are lying to yourself. You set up that channel for yourself. You are simply talking about those pastors because you want to use them to make money. You want to use their church, use their name, use it to make money. And Jesus himself, he will first of all judge you. This is what I say. Many of them will descend on you people. Watch. Because if you are not doing it because of righteousness, because you want Jesus to be glorified, you are simply glorifying them. You are simply advertising them. You are simply making money from them. So they are, you call them the devil, the fake pastor, the devil bait, you are making money from them, which means they give you job, they give you work, you are making money from them, the devil give you work, the fake give you work, and you are standing at the back of the fake. You become the photocopy of the great original fake. So this is what I just want to say in this channel. So many of you is panicking and shaking and trying to make friends with them, or trying to unite with them, or trying to dilute your word, or trying to polish it, you know, to dilute the truth. This is what they are doing. It's a sign, because every man's work must be tested by fire. That your channel must be tested. So your life must be tested. Anything you are saying about Jesus, about every spirit will test you to know whether you are really, really for him. So you will be tested for what you are doing. Many of you are lying to yourself. You don't hate them. You don't hate those fake pastors. You are only jealous of them. You are only you are making your money from them. So, and you disguise that you hate them, but they are the one giving you job. This channel is not where, it's sort of my income. I don't care, as I said to you. Jesus is the one that prospers his own children that he called and sent to do his work. It's not me sitting down and using their sermon and using what they do or advertising their private jet. I am not against them buying private jet. If they are really serving God, have God's spirit, I'm not against it. And I'm not an enemy of God. I love it when my fellow man is making it, you know, making when they are making profit, or maybe from what they're doing, because any businessman must make profit from what he's doing. But if the motive is genuine, if the spirit of God is there, they can't be buying the jet and the heaping those things without affecting the poor or without changing the nation where they are or speaking the truth. So this is the area I'm against. As for material things, I don't put my mind or my eyes on all these things. All I'm after is that if the spirit of God is inside of them, nope, I don't care. But Why I go against them? Why Jesus go against them? Because it's because they are not operating with the Spirit of God. So I want to read this thing before I will end the challenge, so that you I will end the video, so that you also will understand what is going on. Because you are trying to call them fake, and when they begin to threaten you, they need to shake. So, which means you are not sure of the one who sent you, or the one that you are serving, or you are not doing it in love, you are not doing to exalt Jesus and his kingdom. You are doing it for your own selfish interest. I know many of you, God has shown me a lot of all of you. A lot. John chapter 10, I want to read John chapter 10 from verse. John chapter 10 from verse 11, so that you can understand. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd risks and lays down his own life for the sheep. But the hired servants, the good shepherd. Sorry, I do it again. From verse 11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd risks and lays down his own life for the sheep. But the hired servant, he who merely serves for wages, for the money you're making, who is neither the shepherd nor the owner of the sheep, when he sees the wolf coming, deserts the flock and runs away. And the wolf chases and snatches them and scatters the flock. You see danger, as I said to you, you see danger, you begin to run, you begin to panic, or you denounce that I'm not doing it again. I don't believe to Jesus, I didn't say so. You begin to polish your word, I didn't say so. I don't say so about Suleiman. I don't say so about Oedipus. I don't say so. You begin to denounce what you said because you see danger coming. They are threatening, they want to attack your channel. You begin to change your word, change where you talk, you begin to polish it, somehow begin to praise them and dance to their tune and all that, a lot of things going on. So, but if you know whom you are, if they threaten you, threaten back. Come on, threaten my channel, I threaten you back. Straight away. I threaten you back. So this is what I want to say. That if you are truly standing for the truth, you don't need to panic. You need to be strong in the Lord. Be strong in what you are doing. Be strong because you are doing the will of God. But if you are not doing the will of God, you are doing your own will, then you can panic. Because then they can be able to attack and get you. If you are truly doing it for Jesus, there is no way fire will pass through the water and go deep down, there's no way for fire to pass through the fire and go and burn fish. Fire cannot pass water, cannot pass through the water and go and burn the fish that is inside the river or ocean. So this is what I want to say. So, all right, so be blessed. See you some other time and have a wonderful day. Bye.